I wanted to ask you sort of the opportunity around connected TV and sort of what perhaps has been a missing link and what FreeWheel hopes to fill in right there.
The missing link, I think, for everybody is measurement, and the OTT space, different than classic desktop browser-based experiences in the digital ecosystem, means it's really hard to apply data. The signals are different from all the different vendors, from the set-top box experiences to the over-the-top devices and all the apps that come along with it. So we're trying to put this all together, create scale, and apply data measurement so that it's a really transparent, easy to execute environment for buyers that are looking to reach these consumers that everyone knows have drifted away from some of the linear TV exposures that we're all used to, albeit not as grandiose as everyone suggests. I think there's still plenty of scale in TV. In linear TV, we're just all trying to focus on the new living room and the TV being a device rather than it being the distribution means.
So Ryan, fill us in on the elements of the data set, or you know, how you leverage data to make this Drive work.
So Drive is basically a platform for us. We're going to start out with partnering with Nielsen on DAR. So that's their digital ad ratings. We're going to apply age and gender targeting and or measurement and guarantees to our OTT campaigns. It's really exciting for us because we also talk to a lot of linear TV buyers, and they're trying to figure out, how do I do my traditional linear TV campaign with my age and gender and GRPs and also tap into this new supply in OTT? And we're the only people in town really that have this kind of scale on full episode inventory across the TV programmer universe versus a whole bunch of clips or long tail websites that are trying to mimic that experience. So we're really bullish on our ability to help buyers and ultimately help marketers reach all of us as consumers, no matter what screen we're on, in really high value TV programming on any screen.
So is this for buyers who can just buy this product from FreeWheel? Is it part of a suite? Will it be bought by marketers or agencies or both? Tell us about those aspects.
Sure, it really can be bought by anybody. Largely, when we're out there talking with TV buyers, they have a need to try to access this inventory. And so the need needs to be fulfilled by a common metric, and that's why we're starting with Nielsen DAR. As you start to explore different measurement types and all the different data partners that we'll work with out there, making scale against this inventory isn't just a TV buyer's need. Digital buyers are looking for this type of need as well, and they have all sorts of psychographic data that they want to target against, and we'll be able to unlock that on this inventory at scale within the next couple of months.
Great, and some thoughts just here at the ANA, speaking to marketers about their expectations or concerns about television and maybe the path that you guys hope to bring them along?
Yeah, it's exciting because I think one of the nice things about the whole marketplace is the programmers are really starting to cater to all of us as consumers, allowing us to access the content wherever we want and however we want. We're seeing a lot of growth in live TV consumption on apps and connected devices. That's a huge opportunity. That's probably one of the biggest areas that we see growing quickly. The thing that has to happen from a buyer perspective is recognizing it gets delivered differently than a traditional digital video campaign, where you can set a start date and an end date and you evenly pace over the course of the flight. Live happens when live happens. It's a 2-hour window, a game, maybe 3 hours, and all of the impressions and inventories in that particular window on one day. So it's gonna take some time to create a difference in planning and execution, and people acknowledging that it's still great quality inventory, and it's actually really good scale in digital as a complement to TV, but you got to understand it's not going to evenly pace over a 2-week campaign versus it all happening in one afternoon or one evening based on when that live event is happening. So it's really exciting, very encouraging, but I think the ecosystem and the teams that are working in this environment need to advance a little bit more on how they can apply all of this new audience and inventory to their traditional media.